Alright guys, welcome back to Everyday Whiskey. I'm Mike.
And I'm blind.
And this is Balcones Week. So you know Baby Blue very well, which is right over here. We have it on the show quite frequently. As you can see, we've acquired quite a bit more. And
Six bottles in total?
Yes. I think Dan will agree with me on this one, that Balcones has instantly skyrocketed to the top of our list overall.
It definitely hasn't skyrocketed to the top of sales in New Jersey, but it has skyrocketed to the top of our hearts.
We haven't had a bad bottle. There's only one bottle we're still, the jury's still out
and
on.
And I'll get to that when because I know I'm going to be able to pick it out, and I'll get to like why when we get to that bottle and which one it is. But yeah, so Balcones, established in Waco, Texas, it's basically what they do is they do distill, but their main shtick is they blend.
Yes, they're a big blending company, and they blend phenomenally because, as I said, we have not come across a bad bottle yet.
And even their single barrel expressions, like this True Blue Cast Strength here, is amazing. So obviously, they're doing stuff right down there. There's something in Texas water because this is like our fifth episode on something Texas related, and you've probably seen a few of these bottles pop up on other episodes as far as, like, going to Texas or whatever, old-fashioned episodes. But this is the first time we're dedicating an entire episode to Balcones.
Yeah.
So we figured we might as well
have some fun
blindfold me and see if I can. I love this so much. I should be able to pick out each one exactly for which one it is. And Mike's the only one who's going to know.
Yep.
And today we're going to use some special glasses, not sponsored by Balcones, Bellmead, or Bourbon Ware. So, Bourbon Ware glasses are these phenomenal handcrafted leather-wrapped tumblers.
Yes, they are awesome.
Company's based out of Lexington, Kentucky. If you go to bourbonware.com, you can customize your own glasses with your initials, your name, pet's name, website, whatever the hell you want. There are custom leather coasters with a metal horseshoe on top that are sick.
Yeah, those are really cool.
Custom leather flasks. These guys are way too nice, and they sent us two tumblers.
Yeah, they did. They sent them to us, and we did not ask. No, we literally just received a DM saying, hey, guys, what's your address?
And they sent us these. And, like, Mike, I think you said you've used this, like, every night.
I've used this every night for the past 2 weeks since I got it. It is just such a... It's so cool.
Yeah, this supports, like, keep business here, shop local, support small businesses. That's exactly what these guys are, and we love everything about their company.
And you could find a leather-wrapped glass in the store, but, like, these, you could tell the quality of these. They are handmade, no doubt about it.
The leather's hand-stitched on the back.
The leather's actual quality leather. Like, there is a difference between this and what you could find in stores. And
100%.
I love this.
100%.
I'm probably going to buy more.
Yeah, I think the tumblers go for, like, $35 on the website. That's a really good price for what this is. Like, it's worth the money. Take our word for it. I just realized I talk a lot with my hands.
I do too. It's the Italian in me. All
right, so let's get into this.
Yes, but before we start, we'd like you guys to do four things. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe to this channel. All that will help us not bring out more content, because we're always going to put more content, but it'll help us grow and get the word out, and that's all we want.
Get out the word of whiskey. That's the whole point of this. All
right.
All
right. So, Dan, you know all the varieties, right?
Yeah, so...
What I'm thinking I'm going to do is I'm going to pour one, I'll give it to you, and then you tell me which one it is.
Yeah, so we got Pot Still, Baby Blue, True Blue, Rye, Lineage, and Brimstone.
Correct.
Okay. They're all broken down there.
So, first one up. I'll show you guys... We'll see if he can get this.
And don't tell me if I get it right or not. Wait till the end.
No.
Obviously, so I can't deduct.
So I'm going to go down the list here of just the information, tell you a little bit about everything.
Balcones use... All right, so for their blue corn expressions, they do something really cool. They use blue heirloom corn from New Mexico. Only distillery to do that.
Yes, you're right. That's actually one of the key things about this. Hold on, I just got to write down what I just poured. Okay, your glass is right at the corner of the table. All right, so he's going to do this. I'm going to start going down the list. We have...
Okay, this smells very mundane.
We have Pot Still Bourbon, which goes for about $35.99. You have Baby Blue for $44.99. True Blue for $60.99. Rye is back down to $35. Lineage is $44. Brimstone's $59. Now, these prices are subject to change depending your area. This is just our pricing. But as you can tell, there's nothing crazy expensive here. They're all very, very reasonably priced bottles of bourbon, and if you asked me to recommend one in particular, I would say look at the shelf and just grab the first one that appeals to you, because honestly, they're all phenomenal. You can't go wrong.
Okay. This is going to be harder than I thought. This isn't like, it's... every time we do these things, it just gets harder, because you think, you're like,
does.
Oh, I got this. Even because all these are very different. But when you take away eyesight, it really, really kind of messes with... Because this could be, this is one of two. It's either Baby Blue or it's the True Blue Cask Strength. Actually, maybe it's, it could be the Pot Still too.
Shit. All right, so I'm going to start off talking about the Pot Still. The Pot Still, which is this guy right here in front of us. This is a grain to glass. It's won 10 Spirit Awards, and that includes 6 gold medals. It's 100% rye mash bill. It's made with, what the hell is this made with? Elbin rye from Northwest Texas, accompanied by crystal chocolate and toasted rye. I haven't had this, you know, actually, wait, no, I'm thinking of the other thing. I have had this recently.
You own the bottle?
I get a lot of the chocolate and toasted rye out of it, particularly the chocolate. However, wow, you really, like, made sure that was on the glass, on the table. God damn. However, I'd like to change it from, like, dark chocolate to a little bit coffee. I get some
I get
coffee
and milk when I have it.
I get a little bit of that.
So that did taste like the pot still.
Okay, is that what you want to say?
No, but... just because there is a chocolate note, but the chocolate note's in all
of
the bourbon or whiskey expressions. I'm going to say that was... I'll switch them up at the end if I feel like I really mess this up. First, I always screw up the first one. I'm going to go with the regular Baby Blue for that one.
Okay. All right, so now...
because it didn't have enough of a kick to be the cask strength, and I remember the pot still being a little bit lighter.
All right, this will be the next guy up.
It was either the pot still or the Baby Blue. It was one of the two.
I never drank mine. I forgot I had mine here. So I'm going to sip on... Well,
Mike's just along for the ride.
I'm just kind of along for the ride. I'm not going to go taste every single one of them just because I got to drive anyway.
We also found a second use for face masks. You can put them over your eyes.
Yeah. And pull down your little thing. It works as a good nose shield, too. If you need to.
Someone, like, you know, someone smells. You're like, oh, no.
All right. I'm going to keep putting these right on the corner for you.
Yeah, that's fine. That's a good idea.
Let me write down what's next.
Okay.
All right, so next up we have Baby Blue, which is the first Texas whiskey since Prohibition. It's made with roasted blue corn. It's won 10 Spirit Awards and 8 gold medals.
Bitch, man.
This one's hard too, huh?
Dude, I don't know.
I'm going to go back to my first glass. Oh, wow. Yeah, I could see how that first one threw you off.
That's what I'm saying. Like, and this one isn't helping either, because it's got a little more of a kick than the first one.
Mm-hmm.
It's dialed back some of that chocolate note. It could be the... the lineage is very sweet. It's either the...
I hope you don't mind. On the back of each bottle, I'm just putting a little dash so I know which one I poured already, because it's hard for me to see from this angle.
I'm going to go with the lineage on this one.
Okay.
I'm going to go lineage. I just got a little hint of fig that I get in the lineage.
All right. So we talked about that. Cool. All right. You good?
Yes.
You want me to give you a rinse?
Yeah, rinse that out.
All right. Let me give you a rinse.
Here, and then pass a bottle over here so I can wash my palate out a little bit.
Here's the water. It's in my hand.
Thank you.
And here's the... the glass is ready.
For drinking?
Yeah, it's just water in there.
Oh.
I don't know where you want me to dump it, so... usually when I do my rinses, I just drink the water.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Here.
Cool. So,
I definitely think I got that second one wrong. But I'm not sure. I'll switch it up if I feel like I need to.
This one is... I can't say anything about this one.
I've never tasted through all of them at once. So this is interesting.
This is the one I expect you to get. But I could be wrong. Do you need more or less? Have I been giving you enough?
It's fine.
Okay.
It's giving me enough to, like, kind of dissect it a little bit. See, you can go a little less if you wanted to, but it's good.
Well, you're not driving, so. No, I'm kidding. That's the thing about these glasses. If you do a standard bourbon pour, like, it looks like you barely even put anything
in
the glass.
Jesus Christ. All right, this is a rye. I smell the freaking jalapeno pepper. It's the rye. I might have to drink it.
All right, I'll give you one freebie. That is the rye.
The rye? Okay, this is what I'm getting... Oh, God, I really... I alluded to this in the beginning. The rye, I've had everything.
Mm-hmm.
The rye is the only one I'm on the fence about because it's just like, you can't
See,
really
I'm,
use it.
Hold on, I need to try some too.
You can't really use it in old fashioned because the flavors in it are so strong.
They are very strong.
But if you could somehow milk chocolate coat a jalapeno pepper,
mm-hmm.
that's what this tastes like.
So I need to double back. I misspoke. When I said I was describing the pot still, I was actually describing the pot still
See,
rye.
This smells like black tea, though. It smells like unsweetened and black tea, and it tastes like chocolate-covered jalapenos. It's an awesome palate note, but it's just weird. It doesn't fit for me. God bless you, baby.
All right, hold on. I need to try some.
God bless
myself.
You, baby.
This is the one I personally wanted to revisit tonight, because if I remember correctly, I actually wasn't totally opposed to it.
Yeah, you didn't mind it. This tastes
no.
like slightly damp basement. I don't know. Like if you walk into like a new house, and it's got a slightly damp note in their basement. It's like a combination of new house and damp wood. I don't know. It's an odd taste to me.
Next up is one of my favorites to date. I have been drinking this bottle quite a bit. I really enjoy this. So obviously, Danny really enjoyed. We both really enjoy all of.
Yeah, all of them are open. None of them are unsealed.
No.
The one I gave Mike the brimstone when we were in Philly over the weekend, and that we were drinking that all weekend.
Shit.
It was delicious.
All right, there you go.
Balcones Brimstone is one of the best peated whiskeys I've ever had. Easily.
Let me know if you need a refill on that one because I did. Forget
oh, this
to,
is like
I forgot to wash it out.
Really
so.
Sweet. This is really sweet. This has really got that butterscotch note.
Yeah, just let me know if you want a fresh take on that one, because I forgot to wash that one out. I poured it right after the rye. All right, so next up, I want to talk to you guys about the lineage. We kind of just went off on a tangent here, because I knew that one was going to be a problem.
The lineage one's cool. It is. The lineage is actually, it's the only whiskey in America. They use half Scottish barley and half Texas malt. In their blend, and it's phenomenal.
Yeah, and they do that because it celebrates old and new traditions. It's got 5 spirit awards, 3 gold medals. It's another solid product by them.
I retract the lineage I had earlier. This is the lineage.
You want to retract the lineage you had earlier?
Yes.
Okay.
And I think this is the lineage.
Okay.
And then I'll have to revisit the second one. If you want to pour the second one you poured me, again at the end.
Okay, yeah, I'm writing them down in the order that I poured them, so
I think this is the lineage.
Okay. Good. Want to rinse?
Yeah.
No.
Rinse.
Yeah,
actually,
yeah.
Rinse. If that was the one I think it was, rinse.
Do you need a palate rinse or just the glass?
It's the glass.
Okay.
I'm okay palate-wise. Because the glass should do the trick for me.
So hold on, let me just write on the back of the bottle that I did that one. I did that one, that one, that one, that one. Okay, we got 2 left to get through.
This is probably this is one of our smoother blindfolded taste tests we've done.
I like doing it this way, actually.
I think it's a little bit better.
I'm sorry if there's like lack of talk and just I got a lot going on, so I'm trying to.
I can fill in some commentary here.
Decent stuff, but it's gonna flow
the
nicely.
Krusty Krab pizza.
All right.
Is the
so
pizza? That's all I can
do
without copyright.
Yeah. Okay, that one's ready to go.
Alright.
Next, I'm going to give you some info on the Brimstone, which I really like, because as we know, Chan/Mike likes smoking oak. So the Brimstone is smoked with sun-baked Texas scrub oak using a secret process.
I still don't know what scrub oak is.
I was just making sure I was reading that right.
No, it's Texas scrub oak.
And it's secret process, so obviously we don't have any information on the process. Once again, 10 spirit awards, 8 gold medals. As you can see, these guys pretty much, it looks like if I do the math real quick, 5 and 3, 10 and 8, 10 and 8, 5 and 3, they're like above
this
an 80% on all their...
Pot still.
Pot still, you want to say on that one?
I'm going pot still on this. Oh wait, there's that last second hit. That could be cash strength. That really got hot at the end. But the pot still was kind of hot too.
Pot still is weird.
It's a late hitter. I remember it being a late hitter.
It is.
All right, I'm going to stick with pot still on that.
It is, because I was just drinking it the other night when I while gaming, and, like, the first couple sips hit hard. After that, it smooths out. I am not opposed to hard-hitting bourbons, though. I don't mind a little bit of oomph, because as you drink it, you start to warm up to it, and then it smooths out.
I might go, like, 2 for 5 here, or two. I might go, like, 2 for 6 on this shit. It's not possible I get a lot of these wrong.
Rinse or no rinse?
You don't have to rinse that.
Oh, too late.
Alright, just rinse. It actually helps.
I don't know why I even bothered asking when I was in the middle of doing it. Alright, and last but not least, this guy. This one is awesome.
Alright, like I said, once I'm done with this one, pour the second one you poured again, so I can, like,
pour a second again.
Because I haven't guessed cast strength, and I haven't guessed brimstone.
No, you have not. I think I ran through all the... I ran through them all, so we're just having fun at this point. Where is that?
Is it here?
Oh, I didn't even pour it yet.
What the fuck?
I just put it back on the thing. I showed the audience, and I put it back. That was my bad.
Gee, thanks.
Okay.
Give me my grog.
There you go, sir.
All right. Well, this is the brimstone.
Oh, yeah. See, you know what? You were right. Jalapeno on the rye.
Are you still drinking the rye?
Yeah. I just got to drink it, actually, now. I got so caught up.
This is brimstone. It tastes like mesquite.
Really good.
This is brimstone. It's mesquite wood, a little bit of citrus, a nice, like, dark fruit note.
Mm-hmm.
Really good. So that's the brimstone. So I know I got the rye and the brimstone correct.
Oh, my God. Dude, you hit the nail on the head. Chocolate-covered jalapeno.
Yeah.
I like the rye a lot.
Was I correct on this, the brimstone?
Yes.
It's got to be brimstone.
Yeah.
All right. So, all right. Let me get a palate cleanser after this, too.
Okay.
Because this is, like, super smoky. Brimstone is, like, one of my favorite peated expressions ever.
Yes, it's very good.
A very close second. I'm talking about domestic peated. As far as domestic peated goes, it goes brimstone, High West Campfire, Corsair, Triple Smoke.
Yeah.
In that order.
That's a good order. I like that.
I think the Campfire is a little overdone, and it lacks the citrusy, fruity notes you get in some of its Scottish counterparts.
I can tell. I can see that.
But somehow with the Balcones, they didn't try to make a scotch here. They
mm-hmm.
just went for getting a nice, elegant smoke to overlayer it. Because basically, the brimstone is their true blue expression, finished in scrub oak, or smoked in scrub oak. So you get that really nice butterscotch and fruit note,
mm-hmm.
and then the smoke brings this really citrusy and mesquite note to it, and the balance is just, like, uncanny. It's great.
Two.
That's two?
Yes.
I have not guessed True Blue Cast Strength. Which one did I guess the pot still? The fifth one?
One, two, four.
Four? Okay. That tastes very different after trying all of this. Fuck. Fuck.
That's the downside of going back, is because then you really start to second guess things.
All right, I'm switching this.
Mm-hmm.
Put down pasto for number two.
Okay,
and
so
switch whatever I had as a pasto to the True Blue cask.
Okay, what do you think the first one was?
I do think that was baby blue.
Okay. The third we know is rye. Fourth. What do you think the fourth one was? Lineage, right?
Yeah, and then the fifth
yeah.
was pot still, that I guess, but now I'm retracting that as
yeah, you're moving
cast.
That, and then brimstone.
All right, I'm going to pop these off, and we're done now.
Okay. So do you want to hear your results?
I got 2 out of 6 right.
You originally were on track to have every single one
and
right.
I fucked it up?
Yes. You were... So, baby blue, you guessed right. I wanted to do that one first on purpose. Just
it was like,
it's
my favorite one,
yeah.
is baby blue.
You guessed lineage right as the second.
Oh, wow. So retracting was a mistake.
Yeah. Rye, obviously you knew rye. Pot still, I think you actually legitimately fucked up. No, you guessed that.
Pot still is really hard because pot still, all right, so unless you try Balcones, they have this innate basic palate note
mm-hmm.
that is butterscotch and, like, hay. It's
yeah.
like rustic butterscotch. It makes
it's
no
weird.
Sense to say that.
No, I understand.
But if you try it, if you try Lineage, Baby Blue, True Blue, and Pot Still, they all have this base note,
yeah.
and it's awesome. and it's hard to pick out between the three.
It is.
I knew I was going to fuck up these three.
True Cask, you got, was number four, but you said it was Lineage. You switched those.
Really? That was the sweet note.
Yeah,
that
you
was the
switched
thing
Pot
note.
And True.
Mm.
And then Brimstone,
hate
you got.
Hate when I switch Pot.
Yeah. Brimstone, you got. So you were literally on track to nail
the
them.
Easy ones I got. The Rye and the Brimstone are so far out there that if I got those wrong, it means I got hit in the face with a shovel and
yeah.
My nose didn't work. The Baby Blue was that was the one I was worried about being able to pick out because the True Blue and the Pot still share very, very close palate notes.
They do.
Aside from the True Blue is a late hitter, but apparently that late hitter was not the one I missed.
No. You were so on track if you didn't All right. change them.
So we got to figure out a punishment for me since I lost. The punishment will be debuted on
next week's episode.
We're going to talk about a punishment during the live, I guess. So if you guys tune in for the live Tuesday nights after we film, somewhere between 7 and 8, we usually do a live. Jump on in. You got any questions, talk to us, bullshit, drink, whatever.
Yep.
But that's going to sum this up. Thank you to Bourbon Ware for giving us these glasses.
Thanks.
Cheers. These are amazing. Not sponsored by Bourbon Ware. This is a complete plug on our own because of the, you know, the quality of the product. But as Mike said in the first third of the episode, four things you should do. After hopefully you've made it to this point, number one, hit the subscribe button.
Yes.
And if you're subscribing, hit that notification bell. It'll let you know when we are active to the second.
Yep.
Whenever our new episodes drop, which they drop at 9 o'clock in the morning on Fridays.
Yes.
Number two, we need you to like the video, because obviously if you're here at this fucking point, you obviously liked it, or you feel bad for us. Number three, please share the video. It's really good to get this out there. That's the only way that we kind of get some
growth
is by you personally sharing it.
And that's what we want, viewer growth, not monetary growth.
Exactly.
We just want more
people
to see.
Like you said,
us.
We don't need the money. We don't need any of that. We just want people to see what we're doing. We want people to learn about whiskeys they would never learn about. And have fun drinking.
Yeah.
The whole point of bourbon
stops.
Is not to be serious. Holy crap. Like, there's so many people that are so serious about drinking bourbon.
Now.
Just have fun with it. Like, whatever. We get into this every episode at some point. Number three, please comment. Any comment really gets us to know what you guys are thinking, what you like, what you don't like. Apparently, when we did our Whiskey for Beginners episode, we forgot Four Roses OG, the regular Four Roses bourbon.
Oh.
Which was a big blunder on our part.
That's
like, that,
true.
That's been around just as long as Evan Williams, Jack Daniels, and
yeah.
Jim Beam. And there's a fourth one. Like, subscribe, comment, share. We did all four.
Yeah.
All right, so that was four. Sorry. I just had six shots of whiskey, and peace.
Cheers.